Welcome, folks. Thanks for tuning in. This is the first podcast of Lakeland Hunting and Fishing, or Fishing and Hunting the Lakeland, whichever way you want to talk about it. My name is Ken Witchman, and you may have heard me over the years on different radio stations or around the local area, but you know what? I'm done with that. I've retired, they say. Actually, I quit is what really happened, and I am enjoying doing this where I can say what I want when I want about stuff that has to do with the outdoors, and I find that is getting to be more and more important every day. Especially in Alberta, of course, where things are changing so fast, as a matter of fact. You know, as a matter of fact, May 15th, we just passed, and, you know, you have to wear a helmet now when you're on an ATV in the province of Alberta. It's the law. I think it's a great idea. I think it's a long time coming, as a matter of fact. And honestly, why in the heck wouldn't you? I mean, it's safety is first, and safety should be, you know, the main thing when you're out there on an ATV, obviously. Especially learning young kids and first-time riders how to ride. Wear the gear. Wear the proper gear. Be prepared when you're out there also. You know, I always like to pack a nice little, like a survival kit with me in the back of the quad and stuff. So you can spend a night in the bush. Not saying a comfortable night, but a night where, you know, you could survive, obviously. Think about that and make sure you wear your helmet. Other big changes that are happening in the province right now. Well, of course, the big walleye draw system has been expanded this year with many more lakes right across the province. And the big ones for us in this area, of course, are Bourque Lake, Hilda Lake, and Lac La Biche. And Lac La Biche is especially very exciting to me, as a matter of fact, due to the fact that there is some nice quality fish in that. I'm talking big fish in Lac La Biche. So now you can go get them, essentially it was the only people that were taking the walleye out of there were native fisheries up until now, where now the sportsmen can actually get out there. You know, it's going to cost a little bit of money, of course. It's going to cost you money to buy your tag. It's going to cost you money to apply for the draw and stuff like that. But of course, it is worth every cent. I think fishing, you know, people complain about the price of licenses going up all the time, but it's still some of the best, cheapest recreation and, you know, some of the best fun you can have, as a matter of fact, in the outdoors. So don't complain when you got to pay a couple bucks for a tag or you know, an application and that kind of stuff. The interesting thing about the tagging system, it is built up on a point system. So the more you apply, the higher your priority is for the draw, which gives you a better chance of being drawn, for the lake that you want to go after. And around here, like I say, Bourque Lake, Hilda Lake, and Lac La Biche are the big ones. Of course, Pinehurst has it also, but, especially for if you live in Cold Lake, I mean, Bourque Lake, wonderful fish out there. There is fish, you know, 8 pounders not uncommon to come out of Bourque Lake. And now, finally, after all these years, we can finally go after them. And, you know, you'll be able to keep one or two a year. I'm not sure what it is. Obviously, limited harvest is the key. And I can see this happening more and more right across the province, not just on the walleye lakes. I can see this eventually happening to Cold Lake. What's happening to Cold Lake right now is scary. If you've been out here for, you know, fished here for the last, you know, 10 years or so, you really notice a decline in the lake trout fishery. And it is quite sad because, you know, they could have had a great fishery here, but due to, questionable management techniques, to say the least, they've seemed to have taken all the big fish out of the lake. There are good numbers of small fish, so they're saying. But this past winter, I think even numbers of those are down. So it's something to look at in the future. And I really, like I said, I don't mind paying the extra money. And I don't think you should either, folks, because, like I say, they're doing it to limit the fishery. Limit what you take home. That is the key. You can go out there and catch and release all you want. I'm surprised how many people don't want to go catch and release. It is the very normal in most fisheries right across North America, as a matter of fact, that catch and release fishing is the only way to do it, as a matter of fact, in so many fisheries. So we're just going to have to get used to it here in Alberta. Of course, you know, the tag system does open up another can of worms, and that goes to, well, why do we have to go in a tag system when, Aboriginal people can go in there and set nets and stuff like that whenever they want? How can that even make a difference, the tag fish that we take out? Well, it does. There is a lot of anglers in this province. I forget what it is per square acre or hectare of lake. There's like, 20 anglers per square hectare. So heavy pressure from the sports fishermen also. So at least we are doing something about it. And you know what? Every time you buy a license, money from your license goes back into the resource, whether it's hunting, fishing, whatever it is. So you know what? Think about that when you're out there. And I can guarantee you that the Aboriginal people buying nets, none of their money is going back into helping the fishery. So be proud as a sportsman out there. You know what? Just because you can do it and you got the right doesn't mean it's right. Also, all the other folks out there that are setting nets in certain lakes across the area, you know who you are. I'm not going to get into specifics, but there is an issue with that, and it's not going to go away anytime soon, as a matter of fact. I want to get to hunting right now. Bear hunting has been super hot in the last couple weeks. There was nothing the first couple times at the bait. Now they are coming along just crazy. The bears are coming in, getting sows and cubs. We're getting nice big boars, color phases, the whole nine yards. If you're a bear hunter right now, although it looked like a slow start to the season, it looks like it's really going to be picking up here in the next month or so. And you know what? People talk to me and they give me the gears all the time about bear hunting, and they're saying, how is that sporting, hunting over a bait? How is that sporting, you know, watching an animal and then, you know, watching them interact with a bait and stuff and then shooting them, taking the meat, whatever it is. Well, number one, it's called hunting, and that's what we do. We hunt. And, you know, actually with a bait, it is probably the most humane way you can to take an animal. I don't care what kind of animal, whether it's a deer, whether it's a moose, elk. Not saying it's legal in Alberta, it's not, as a matter of fact, but the bear hunting is legal in Alberta, and it's a great way to make sure that you get a good shot on the animal that you're taking. Take the proper firearm, obviously. I like to use a 45-70. I know a lot of folks use everything from 7mm 08s to 30-30s, you name it, that's been used in bear hunting. The great thing that we've been doing on our bait in the last several years is sitting on the ground. I find it so exciting. We're sitting there and you're interacting with these animals 40 yards from you, right on the ground. You know, basically you're on the same footing they are. When you're up in a tree stand, you feel a little safer, obviously, although there is times where they have climbed the tree stand and have, you know, came up after us. It is completely different when you're sitting on the ground and one of those big animals moves in to that bait and they know, you know, they know something's up on there and you got to be quiet. But you realize as a hunter, you are not the top of the food chain. It is so exciting. If you have not taken anybody bear hunting or have not tried it yourself, try hunting on the ground. Just make sure you be safe out there. Always good to go with two people, so always have a backup and stuff like that. These guys that hunt with the bow and arrow, I mean, they have, you know, solid plutonium noids. I'll tell you, they're tough guys out there sitting there doing nothing, you know, with nothing but a pointy stick for that matter, and they're out there. Some of these animals are up to, you know, 400 pounds, so we're talking a great big carnivore, omnivore, whatever you want to call them. They, you know, they are, like I say, the top of the food chain. It's very exciting. If you have not tried it, get out there and do it. There are lots of bears. There's nothing to be, you know, worrying about, you know, putting a dent in the population, because no matter how many bear hunters we have, it will not put a dent in that population. They've been so under-harvested for years and years and years that they've got a population right across North America, for that matter. Recently, there was a story in Toronto where the police had to shoot one right in Scarborough. So, you know, think about that. They are a very adaptable animal, very cool animal. If you have not tried it, get out there and do it, of course. You know, one thing about living up north here in northern part of Alberta is we do have a lot of crown land available to us. And it's interesting because right across North America right now, one of the biggest threats to fish and game hunting and fishing and all that kind of stuff is not habitat loss from industrialization, from, for example, oil companies tearing up leases or logging companies going in and logging vast tracts of land. It is private ownership of what was once public land. It is being bought up right across North America. Every state has this problem. I mean, even Texas, I think there's less than 5% of the land is now public land in Texas. Although it is a great big state, obviously 5% is still a lot of land. I mean, but it's just amazing that most of it is privatized right now. And it's happening in every other state, just about, you look off right across the map. And sportsmen's group are fighting this out there, and, you know, to little avail. I mean, big business, big money always seems to take over from, you know, the little guy and status quo and all that kind of good stuff. So is it happening in Alberta? Well, I'll tell you what, it is happening in southern Alberta right now, and it is scary. You see the amount of people, whether it's a religious sect, for example, or, you know, a certain group of people buying all the land on there and privatizing it for their own uses, whether it's farming or even opening up outfitting businesses and stuff like that, or just plain big ranchers. There's a lot of that going on in southern Alberta right now, and don't think it cannot happen in northern Alberta. That's why you've got to be strong as a voice. We've got to let our voices be known to the politicians. Join the sportsmen's groups, all that kind of good stuff, to keep a strong voice for hunting and fishing in the area, because if we lose it, once it's gone, I can guarantee you it will not come back. You know, the May long weekend's coming up, and I'll tell you what, I used to be really, really excited about May long weekend and opening day, but the way it's going in this province, I'm not excited anymore. I almost dread it, as a matter of fact. Seems it brings out the worst of the worst out of the woodwork, and then showing up at the boat launches and off-roading in the back country and stuff like that. You get all the a-holes that think May long weekend is nothing but a big piss up to get out there with their buddies, get hammered up and do stupid shit on the water or in the forest and stuff like that. You know what? Don't put up with it. If you're out there on May long weekend and you see that kind of stuff happening, phone them in right away. We don't need this kind of stuff in Alberta's outdoors or any outdoors for that matter. And you know what? It gives all sportsmen a ridiculously bad name. So think about that. Get out there, enjoy yourself. You know what? Have fun. Take the family with you. That's what it's all about. Don't let the weather slow you down. I know this year it's a little cool this year. Cold Lake still got a lot of ice on it, so that should keep a lot of idiots out of here for at least a week or so until that ice comes off, and then we get the influx of all the experts from right across the province that have been to Cold Lake 3 or 4 times, and they're all lake trout experts, as a matter of fact. Well, I'll tell you one thing, you experts, it's going to be a lot tougher this year for you to catch fish. You're going to have to really, probably should start listening a little bit more and start and quit talking, and you might learn how to catch a little bit more fish out there, because you know what, it's getting tough, not just on Cold Lake, but just about every lake in the area. Little Bear Lake, it's shocking right now, the amount of water, the water level has dropped down there. It is phenomenal. It's out 30 yards from shore. Where did it go? There's so many theories out there. I mean, it is a spring-fed lake. Has the oil companies finally cracked into an aquifer where they're sucking the water out of the lake? I doubt it. There's talk about that. But, you know, a few miles down the road, Ethel Lake is and Tulip are as high as they've always been. So it is something weird. I don't know what's happening there. Hopefully they do stock it. The rumor is they're stocking with rainbows, browns, and brookies this year. That's what I heard. I don't know exactly how true that is. But you know what? The only way you're going to know is get out there and, you know what, do some fishing this weekend. Do some bear hunting this weekend. Get out there, do some camping this weekend. It's a great time to break out the camper for the first time of the year. Sit around a campfire. Talk about what your season, what you're looking forward to this year. The stuff you're going to do. And you know what? Just get out there, enjoy the outdoors. Folks, my name is Ken Wichman. This is Fishing and Hunting the Lakeland. And you know what? Check us out on Facebook. I'll be putting this on there now. And then, of course, in the future, stay tuned for more stuff.